By your word. Father, we ask the Lord, your word become expressly unto us in the name of Jesus. We hear no man speak unto us, O Lord. Lord, I would decrease and you will increase in the name of Jesus. Lord, Holy Spirit, we ask that you breathe over the word of life, that the word that we hear, O Lord, will change our lives, will encourage us, will lift us up, O Lord. Another day of glory, O Lord. This word that we are going to hear, O Lord, this afternoon will not stand against us in the name of Jesus. Father, we give you praise, we give you glory. In Jesus' mighty name we are praying. Praise the Lord, church. Matthew 14, 29 and 30. Please, technical. And he said, come. And when Peter was come down out of the ship, he walked onto the water to go to Jesus. 13. But when he saw the wind boisterous, he was afraid. And beginning to sing, he cried, saying, Lord, save me. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. We can see from the passage that not that the wind was not there. The wind was when, you know, God, Jesus asked him to walk upon the sea. The wind was still there, but because he was looking at Jesus, because he fixed his eyes on Jesus, he wasn't seeing the wind. He was not seeing the wind. But as long as he fixed his eyes on Jesus, it was okay. He was going towards Jesus. He was going to meet Jesus. But the moment he started looking at the wind, the moment he moved his eyes away from Jesus, he started seeing the wind blowing, boisterous. and it started sinking. We will not sink in the mighty name of Jesus. We will not shift our gaze from the King of Kings in Jesus' name. So if you want to give title to this ministration, we can say, looking unto Jesus. Looking unto Jesus. The Bible says in Hebrews 12:2 that we should look unto Jesus, the author and finisher of our faith. He's the author and finisher of our faith. He's the beginning. He's the one that knows from the end to the beginning. So that's why we need to look unto him. Everything that concerns us, our journey here on earth, is all about Jesus. He knows everything. So that's why we need to look unto him, Jesus, the author and finisher of our faith. Praise the Lord. So you come to him when you look not, you look unto him, not at him. Praise the Lord. You can look at somebody, just look at somebody, but you're not looking unto that person. You are not expectant. Praise the Lord. You are not looking with a purpose. Praise the Lord. You are just looking, looking. Praise the Lord. You know, you see that everybody look. You are just looking. It's not looking. We are not talking about when you are saying looking unto Jesus. It's not about looking, look. Praise the Lord. It's looking with an expectant heart. Praise the Lord. It's looking to receive something from him. Praise the Lord. So some of us, we look at him, not unto him. And so we don't come unto him. When you are looking at him, you don't see any need to be expectant to come and to go to him to receive something from him. So how do we do that? When we have problems, we have challenges, we have difficulties, name it. We stay in that sphere, in that mood, in that state of despair, in that fear, in that discouragement. Instead of coming unto him, instead of looking unto him, we look at our challenges. We look at the storm, the wind around us. Praise the Lord. We look at the difficulties. We can only see the challenges around us. We can only see the trials. We can only see the failures. We can only see the disappointment. We can only see the lack. We can't see anything beyond that because we are not looking unto Jesus. We fix our eyes on the things that are bothering us, on the things that are challenging us. If you are looking unto him, it definitely will look unto him. We will not take thought for our life. Praise the Lord. We will not take thought for our life. If you look unto him, we will not take thought of our lives. Matthew 6:25, 32 and 33. So if you are looking unto somebody that you know is the Alpha and the Omega, is the author and finisher of your faith, why are you then still bothering about the things that are, you know, still thinking about things that are not working out fine? He said, therefore I say unto you, take no thought for your life, what you shall eat or what you shall drink, nor yet for your body what you shall put on. It's not the life more than means, and the body more than raiment. 32, please. He said, for after all these things, do the Gentiles seek, the unbelievers, everybody, they seek after such things. For your heavenly Father knoweth that all that you have need of all those things. Praise the Lord. Your heavenly Father, he knows that you need job. He knows that you need that child. He knows that you need that breakthrough. He knows that you need that healing. Praise the Lord. And he's the one admonition. We should take no thought for all those things. Because he knows that there's a tendency for us to be thinking about it. So some of the things that we read in the Bible is not just by mistake, by it's not just there. He knows that as long as we're in this flesh, in this world, there's a tendency for us to be looking at, to be taking thought of all those things that we know that bothers us. But it's admonition. He said, take no thought for them. As you look unto him, you will fear nothing. Praise the Lord. So please, don't let us look at the things that are facing us, the challenges that are facing us. Let's fix our eyes on Jesus, the author and finisher of our faith, because he's the Alpha and the Omega. He knows everything from the beginning to the end, and he loves us so much. So he also said, come unto me, all ye that labor. He knows that we will labor. You are heaven laden, you are burdened. Praise the Lord. He said, come unto him. So there are provisions for us. So we don't have to be burdened. Praise the Lord. And if you are burdened, he said, come unto me. And what leads to burdens? Worry. Worry leads to burden. You begin to worry. Praise the Lord. You begin to carry it on your head. When somebody has already finished it, he said on the cross, it is finished. But you say, no, let me, it's my, you don't know, it's my problem. You know, we say it as same, it's my problem. You say, that's my problem. It's not your problem. Praise the Lord. He said, give me all your burdens. Praise the Lord. Give me all your burdens. So what is it that you are burdening yourself about? that we begin to meditate. You know, some of us, we meditate on, and that's the trick of the devil. You will not have time to meditate on the word of God. But your problem, God have mercy. I've been waiting on the Lord for these past years. God, when you will be thinking about it, then the devil will be signposting you to other things that you need to be thinking about. Yes, amen. You see all your mates now? They've had it. They've had children. You have not. All of your mates, they are doing fine. See, you are just managing. What is it? You know, the devil will now be expanding the thing. Is it not the word of God that we should let the Holy Spirit expand to us? But we allow the devil to expand those challenges and problems. You don't have this, you don't have that. You worry about bills, finances, our jobs, our health, you know, your academics, your family, your future. Praise the Lord. As many that are burdened this day, I decree and declare in the mighty name of Jesus that those burdens be lifted up in the mighty name of Jesus. Those burdens, whatsoever they are, as he has said, come unto me, all ye that are labor and heavy laden, and I will give you rest. As you have come into his presence this afternoon, those burdens shall be lifted up in the name of Jesus, and you shall have your rest, you shall have your peace in the mighty name of Jesus. Psalm 199 verse 18 says, open my eyes that I may see wondrous things. Praise the Lord. There's this song that said, open the eyes of my heart, Lord. Open the eyes of my heart, Lord. I want to see you. I want to see you. To see you, I lift it up. Shining in the light of your glory. Pour out your power and love as we sing, holy, 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 holy. I want to see you. Praise the Lord. So what are you seeing? Are you seeing his wonderful promises? Praise the Lord. Are you seeing his wonderful promises, or you are just seeing those problems and challenges? He said, behold, I'm with you, even unto the end of the world. I will never leave you nor forsake you. He said, we are more than conquerors. To Christ that loved us. Praise the Lord. He loves us. He said, behold, what manner of love that the Father has given unto us. So let's encourage, brethren, let's encourage ourselves, you know, in those things. Instead of meditating, let's shift. Praise the Lord. When the devil brings in something to you, shift, you know. Just say, no, I'm not going to dwell. Because it's going to come. Don't let us deceive ourselves. For what are you going to do when those thoughts start coming? When the devil wants to start to meditate on those things, that those challenges that you are facing. So, you know, you shift. You shift. For me, one thing that I've started, you know, doing these days is like, you know, the birds of the air, they feed. The Bible says that, they don't, do they have a farm or something? Or do they have something that they have? They don't have anything, praise the Lord. So those things, that's what I've been meditating the past couple of months. I'll tell my husband, me, I don't bother. The bird safe is feeding them, is taking care of them. So he will take care of me now. He knows that I need them to pay my bills. He knows that I need money. He knows that so he will take care of me because he's my father. And he has said so. So I don't bother myself. He will sort it out, praise the Lord. So don't bother yourself. He will sort it out because he's your father. As if he can do it for the birds of the air, he will do it for you in Jesus' name. Yeah. Elisha and his servant, you know that story when Elisha, they came, you know, to attack Elisha, and you couldn't see, but was just seeing the what's it called now? The chariots, praise the Lord. You couldn't see anything. And Elisha just asked God to open the eyes of the servant so that he can see. And what did he see?
Horses and chariots.
So if God can just open our eyes to see the battle that God is fighting for us, we'll keep calm. Praise the Lord. We'll keep calm. But it's because our eyes are not open to see what God has, you know, in store for, what God is doing for us. So we begin to fear, we begin to tremble. Praise the Lord. We begin to fear, we begin to tremble. May the Lord open our eyes in Jesus' name. And also the Jesus' disciples, we know that what happened? God told them that he's going to die and resurrect. But then at the end of the day, they couldn't even identify him. They couldn't see him until God opens his eyes. The Lord will open our eyes to see his wonderful promises in the mighty name of Jesus.
And as we see that, we have an act of
gratitude in the mighty name of Jesus. Praise the Lord. There was this story of the blind man that was in the train and was going. And just God, his sight, you know, restored somehow, anyhow. And he was just looking at them and said, wonderful. bathroom, just looking. And there was this lady beside him and said, what is wonderful about all these bushes and all these not good sights that the man is saying, wonderful, wonderful. She didn't know when. What is wonderful? And the man, the blind man said that the man that you know, can see, I've been blind, you know, for so many years, and my eyes are now open. So whatever I see is beautiful. Praise the Lord. So grumbling blinds our eyes to God's blessings, because we cannot see that He's at work in our lives. We cannot see what He's doing. So the little that we have, we begin to grumble. We begin to say, "This job, safe. This job." Some people are looking for that job, they cannot get you. You are already grumbling. And I know when you're asking for that job, you'll be praying, fasting and praying. And when you get the job, you say, this job, safe. Human beings will be complaining again. You are asking for children, these children, you will not kill me. Oh, hey, God, have mercy, these children. Some people are looking for children. Praise the Lord. So those things that we complain about, we should stop complaining and say that, you know, they are just, we are all work in progress. Praise the Lord. And they are all stepping stones to greater glory for us in the mighty name of Jesus. So whatever we are, the situation that we had now, that we are looking at, that we are thinking that it's not the best for us, they are just stepping stones to greater glory in the mighty name of Jesus. So what you look onto will impact on your thoughts, your feelings, and attitudes. Praise the Lord. So what you look onto, that's why I said, shift your focus, shift your, if the devil is saying, blah, blah, because it will come, you're saying, okay, you see, just shift, you know, your attention to the things of God, to the word of God, to what God has said. Like I told you, my, if the devil wants to start blah, blah, blah to me, I'll just tell the devil, see the boss now. God is providing for them. He will provide for me, no shaking. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. So what you look onto will impact on your thought, because that's what we'll be thinking about. You will know, your eyes will be blind to see any good that God has done or God is doing, because you just be looking at that thing. What you see, you are just seeing the problem. You are seeing that, oh, you can't pay your bills. You are seeing that your children are, you only see that your children are not doing well. That's what you are seeing. It will impact on what you're feeling, your attitude. You become miserable. You are worried and blah, blah, blah. These children, what, blah, blah. Hey, my husband. You cannot even see the good in your husband. What you are saying is, my husband is really doing. Look at the good things that God, you know, the grace of God upon you, the life of your husband, upon the life of your children. And look at all those things. Think on all those things. Don't think at the negative part of it. Praise the Lord. And look away from those storms. Look away from those challenges. Look away from the help of man. Look away from yourself. Praise the Lord. You cannot help yourself. He said, by strength shall no man prevail. Do we have any strength of our own? No. We can't do nothing without Him. So you cannot help yourself. And man cannot help you. What does the Bible say, that the help of man is vain? Praise the Lord. So don't look at unto man, because man will disappoint you. Don't look at anybody. People will disappoint you. Praise the Lord. Don't look at your husband. I tell my children, don't say it's mommy and daddy that will meet all your needs. No, it's God that will meet all your needs. Praise the Lord. If you have that mentality, God can do anything any way that He wants to do. So, but if you are just straight, it's mommy and daddy that will do this for me, then if mommy and daddy cannot do it, then you'll be disappointed. That's why, you know, you say, what you're expecting, you get disappointed because of the expectations. When you look onto somebody and they don't meet that expectation, that's when disappointment comes. But when you don't care, you don't look at anybody, you are not expecting anything from anybody, you won't be disappointed. Praise the Lord. But we should only look onto Jesus, the author and finisher of our faith. Praise the Lord. Isaiah 45:22 says, look unto me and be ye saved. Look unto me. You know, when I was, you know, preparing for this, anytime that you see God, when He said look unto, there's an action. Praise the Lord. Something follows that. Go and do the Bible study, check it. When God said He looked down onto the army of the Egyptians, what happened? Destruction. Anytime God is, something is happening, there will always be an action. Praise the Lord. There will always be an action. So He said, look unto me, you people of Seir Peribah, and be saved.
Amen.
So He's not talking about being saved, your salvation. Saved, salvation from whatever we are going through. When we look unto Him, we shall be saved in the mighty name of Jesus. Hebrews 2:9 says that, talking about the disciples, and we say, but we see Jesus. So who are you seeing? We see Jesus. Who or what are you seeing? Are you seeing the enemy? Fine, the enemy is there. But are you looking at them? Are you looking at, is it only the enemy that you are seeing? The enemy will always be there till we go to heaven. Because the devil has been thrown down here to come and do his work. But Jesus Christ said, it is finished.
Hallelujah.
It is finished on the cross of Calvary. So no matter what you are going through, it is finished.
Amen.
Tell yourself, it is finished. That problem, it is finished. That challenge, it is finished. Whatever, it is finished.
No more sorrow.
Psalm 34 verse 5 says, they look unto him, and what happened? And we are lightning, and their faces were not ashamed. When you look unto him, they look unto him, they were lightning, and their faces were not ashamed. As you look unto Jesus this afternoon, your faces will be lightened, and you will not be put to shame in the mighty name of Jesus. Everything that represents shame will not come near you in the mighty name of Jesus. 2 Corinthians 4:18 says that we look not at things which are seen, but the things which are not seen. For the things which are seen, they are temporal. But the things which are not seen, they are eternal. Praise the Lord. So stop looking at those challenges. Stop looking at how your finances, that is your account, that is in red, or that you are in debt. Praise the Lord. Stop looking at those children that you think that, oh, they are not behaving well. Stop looking at that. Praise the Lord. Look at the promises of God over your life. Look at what is God saying concerning that situation. Those are the things that we should be meditating upon. He said our children are for signs and wonders. Even when they are not, it seems as if I can't see any sign or wonder that they are, that I can't see now. But then, that's what the word of God says. So we begin to prophesy into their lives. Our children are for glorious signs and wonders in the mighty name of Jesus. In Numbers 21, we all know the account that when they sinned against God and they were murmuring and blah blah blah, and God sent fiery serpent and they were biting and they were killed, and God now they prayed as they always do, they pray, and God, merciful God, answered them and said that Moses should do the brazen serpent and put upon the pole. And as many that looked unto that, when the snakes bite them, they will not die, they will be healed. Praise the Lord. And we have that Jesus Christ that was lifted up. Said as Moses was lifted up, so the Son of Man was lifted up on high. Praise the Lord. He died on the cross of Calvary for us. So in the mighty name of Jesus, I pray that as many of us that need healing in one area of our lives, physical healing, spiritual healing, whatever healing that we are looking unto Jesus for, because he died on the cross of Calvary for us, and he said it is finished. Receive your healing in the mighty name of Jesus. Whatever healing that you are believing God, I decree and I declare today that you receive your healing in the mighty name of Jesus. The King of Glory, the mighty one of the mighty man of war, will bring about that healing speedily this morning in the mighty name of Jesus. And Moses and the burning bush, we all know the account of Moses and the burning bush. Praise the Lord. The bush was burning, but the fire was not consumed. But the bush was not consumed, praise the Lord. And he said, bush, I can see fire burning, but the bush is not consumed. Now let me look. Let me go and look and see what is happening. Praise the Lord. And he looked, he went there and looked. And God met with him. Because he went to go and see that wonder, to come and see that wonder. Praise the Lord. The Almighty will do miracles in our lives in the mighty name of Jesus. As we look unto him, he will turn us around. The miracles that will turn us around, he will do in our lives in the mighty name of Jesus. He will do in our lives in the mighty name. So I'm admonishing us, please, brethren. Look unto him. Just look unto him for anything. Don't look unto man. Don't look unto anything. Don't look at your abilities, your qualifications, whatever. Just look unto him. Because he's the author and finisher of our faith. He's the Alpha and the Omega. He's got everything that we need in life. And he loves us. He's our Father. He loves us. So please, look unto him. No matter what challenges you are facing, don't let the devil draw you into that state that you begin to. Because that what leads to whatever you call it. You start meditating, looking at it. Oh, I don't have this. I don't have that. I don't have that. Stop looking. Just that what God has made provision for him. He said he has blessed us with all spiritual blessings in heavenly places. He has given us everything that pertains to life and godliness. Praise the Lord. He's made provision for everything. It's just for us to tap. Instead of looking at those things that we don't have or those challenges, look at the Word of God. What is the Word of God saying about that situation? What is the Word of God saying about that circumstances? And begin to meditate on that, not on the challenges that you have. And as you do that, your life will never remain the same in the mighty name of Jesus. But you cannot look unto Him if you don't know Him. Praise the Lord. Somebody that you don't know, you can't look unto Him. So as many of us that are here, that we don't know Him, I'm not talking about religion, that you don't have a personal relationship with Him, come unto Him. He's ready to receive you. Come unto Him. He's ready to receive you. So if I have any one of us, anyone that wants to give their life to Christ, I want you to bow down your heads and just pray to Him and ask Him to come into your life and receive you so that you will know Him and you'll be able to look unto Him in Jesus' mighty name. If you know that you are burdened and it seems that, you know, you are looking at the storms, because you are looking at the storm, the challenges that you have burdened, and those things are beginning to give you concerns, and you are discouraged, or you are like Peter, that you're already sinking or about to sink, please, I want us to stand up if you are in that category, and the pastor will pray for us. If you know that you are already burdened, He said, come unto me, all ye that are burdened and are heavy laden, and I will give you rest. If you know you are in that category, please stand up and let the pastor pray for us.
Got any burden? If you got any heaviness in your heart, please let's come together, let's set the cult free so that the King of Glory will ride upon even that body. Lord of Kings will ride upon that body and His name will be glorified. He ruled upon the court that had never been sat on before. That court can be likened to challenges of life that you have not seen the solution to before. You have not walked this path before, but He rode on that court and He was glorified. Begin to ask that, Father, I present this matter before You. I present this issue before You. I look not at my problem, I look up unto You. Lord, ride upon this issue and glorify Your holy name. The choir can be saying, glorify Your name. Glorify Your name. Father in heaven, glorify Your holy name. Glorify Your holy name. Concerning this matter, begin to ask that the Almighty God, Father, glorify Your holy name. Glorify Your holy name. I bring this matter before You. Glorify Your holy name, O Lord. Glorify Your name, O Lord. This matter, Lord, even as we are using this day, today is being celebrated all over the world as Palm Sunday. When Jesus was lifted high, even physically, Father, glorify Your holy name. Just like we shouted Hosanna at that time, let Your name, O Lord, be glorified concerning this matter. Begin to say, Father, glorify Your holy name. Turn this matter to testimony. Sheke Baba Sotoroko. Yereke Baba 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 Basere Lima. Thank You, Jesus. Sheke Baba Sere Lima. Yereke Masoto Kima Shara Lama Baba. Yere Lima Baba 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 Seke Baba 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 Sheke Baba 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 Baba. Father, glorify Your name. Glorify Your name, my Father, my God. You are God who can do all things. You are God who can do all things. Glorify Your holy name.
Glorify Your name.
Glorify Your name.
Father, glorify Your name.
eternal rock of ages, Heavenly Father, you have released your word, and that which your word does, healing. That which your word does, deliverance from all troubles. That which your word does, setting free. Father, let your word that you have released this day begin to do your works. Let it begin to do your acts. Your mighty acts, O Lord. The one that turns the tide for good. Let your word begin to do that in the lives of your children. Glorify your name, O God. I commit these issues that your children have brought as that ass that needed to be set loose, upon which you will ride, and your name shall be glorified. I pray in the name of Jesus for divine intervention. I pray for a touch of the Almighty. I pray in the name of Jesus that these are laid before you. Just as that young man was laid before you by his friends. I pray in the name of Jesus that these matters are laid before you. Amen. Set loose. Amen. Change for good.
Amen.
Turn every strange songs to songs of praise.
Amen.
Turn every pain to comfort.
Amen.
Turn every struggle to rest.
Amen.
Turn every pain, O God, to comfort.
Amen.
Every blurry situation, Father, let there be clarity.
Amen.
Where there is no way, Jehovah Lord, make a way.
Amen.
Turn these matters, O Lord, around.
Amen.
And let them be point of testimony.
Amen.
To the glory of your holy name.
Amen.
Jehovah Lord, we receive your intervention with thanksgiving.
Amen.
In the name of the Father.
Amen.
In the name of the Son.
Amen.
In the name of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.